And now, ladies and gentlemen, this week on the Show of Shows, we present Captain Kremen, starring the thing that goes... What new filth and glurg is about to spill out of your radio? Find out in this disgusting episode, coming soon. Also, stand by for Harry Nilsson's new single, Big Monster Prize... Thank you, sound effects department. Excuse me. Now, where was I? Oh, yes. Classics, oldies, and the top 40 in this week's Kenny Everett Show. Brought to you by Kremen's Dandruff Aid.
Hello, may I help you?
Yes. I'm looking for a dress.
I have just the thing for you. Look at this lovely black dress.
Oh, I can't wear black. I have terrible dandruff.
You should try Kremen's Dandruff Aid.
Oh, I've tried dandruff shampoos. They just don't work.
Kremen's isn't a shampoo. It's a dye.
Oh?
It turns your dandruff black, so you can't see it when it falls on your dress.
Ooh, knife.
Ooh,
ooh, Cliff. Ooh.
Ee.
Ooh. Ee.
Well, Cliff, thanks for coming on board Radio Victory.
Thank you, Ken.
You're welcome. Phil Spector rides again on Victory with Frosty the Snowman by
The Ronettes.
Hi, Kenny, we're the Beach Boys. You want to do us this week?
Oh, thanks, fellas.
You're welcome.
Okay, guys out there. You know the words? God Only Knows by the Beach Boys. We're going to take away the Beach Boys, leave you with the backing track so you can sing along. Here we go.
I may not always love you.
The roar of the sea and the swell of the surf. Doesn't it remind you of those happy summer days when the kids used to bury you up to your neck in sand and you used to sit there chuckling as the sea rolled on towards you and everything would...
Radio Victory, the station that's as beautiful as you are.
I recall as I tumbled through the years and made a man of me.
fall. Yes, I was what healthy girls expect a man to be. A guy who rolled the dice, who took things just as they came. But now I plan ahead, my life's just not the same. You stole me, you changed me, you rearranged me.
One woman man.
A guy is quick to fall in love and then falls out again. Well, I've played around, but not with hearts and hopes, but just a loving game. The man I thought I was is not the man I am now. It takes a special girl to make seeds turn into flowers. So special, so lonely, my one and only. You can't control me.
One woman man.
That's gentleman called Leroy Brown on Victory with One Woman Man on EMI Records. Hi there, Portsmouth. And now, Heartstring Twangers Limited bring you something to whisk you off to fairyland as Wireless Workshop Productions, in association with the Aunt Mildred Heavy Construction Company, bring you...
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
Yes, Victorians, here it comes. If you've ever seen Pinocchio by Walt Disney, this will relive dynamic memories for you. If you haven't, go and see it. It's divine.
For me, where every day is a holiday and kids have nothing to do but play. Hi diddly do, if what I hear is true, a land of pudding and marmalade is Pleasure Isle for me.
When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Oh, Walt, you'll find your dreams come true. Pinocchio, recorded in about 1940 or thereabouts, and we missed one tune out. Guess what it is?
Yes, you're right.
When you get in trouble and you don't know right from wrong, give a little whistle. Give a little whistle.
Comedy break.
I like to see Raquel Welch in a sweater. It's the way she pulls your eyes over the wall.
Are you kidding me?
That's what happens when you plug Carol into the mains. Ebenezer Moog on Rocket Records, and God rest ye merry gentlefolks. We have a little breaky-poo coming along right now on Victory 257 AM and 95 FM, and right after that, it's the last episode of Captain Kremen. And now, Radio Victory, the station that rescued you from the BBC, brings you your very own space radio serial. Brought to you this week by Kremen's Airlines.
This is Nancy's first flight on Kremen's Airlines. She doesn't know it, of course, but Kremen's took 17 years to train Nancy's captain. 17 years. She got one of the dumb ones.
We present Episode 9 of Captain Kremen and the Krell People, starring Billabong and Natalie Dressed in... Blech! Hi, kids. Kremen here. Well, at last, this was it. Those filthy beast fiends, the Krells, had forced me to blast planet Earth with liquid Thrawn. The deadly ray shot its way down into the heart of London.
Well, Kremen, a good shot. 9 million people crammed into a few square miles.
Little did he know that although I had aimed the Thrawn ray into the center of London, it would kill no one. For I had aimed it at the only place in the crowded city where I knew that no one would be. Center point. It toppled like a pack of cards. Meanwhile, the thing that goes... had marched on Westminster and set itself up as the government. People were powerless to stop it. Already it had assumed control and was delivering its first orders to the quivering members of the House.
The man said is that an unable wealth. Not even to another. The man is
Yeah.
I just couldn't stand by and let Britain be ruled by this thing. Harry
world was bad enough, but a 40-ton heap of purple jelly? Never. I swung the Krell Thron gun around, took aim, and delivered a salvo straight into the center of the thing. Suddenly, I knew the thing had had it, for from under a pile of rubble, I heard...
I give up.
The nation went wild. The Queen demanded an audience with me. The next day, the Krells surrendered, and I drove to the palace.
And on this great day, Her Majesty is walking slowly towards the podium to deliver this announcement, wearing a beautiful gown made entirely of lettuce and cucumber with hand-embroidered shrimps. And on this grand occasion, of course, she's wearing the state vegetables. That's the sash of the Grand Order of Beef and Tomato, set off beautifully by the tiara, which I'm told is fashioned entirely out of prawn and celery squares on a background of ham and onion, crowned with a magnificent roast shoulder of pork. She pauses gracefully to dab a little HP behind each ear and mounts the podium.
For valor above and beyond the call of duty, and for bravery in face of Krells, I name you Sir Captain Kremen.
A lump came to my throat, and a searing shaft of pain hit my body as she pinned the medal to my chest. Well, my job here was done. I was given a fresh ship, a fresh crew, and a fresh set of underwear, and was off again once more into space, searching new adventures. Join me again soon, and we'll discover the cosmos together. Oh, not a dry eye in the house. Stand by next week for episode one of a whole new series of Captain Kremen and the Gremets.
It gets worse.
That's good old Maxine, right back where she started from, and she's slipping down the charts, unfortunately. Shame to see a jolly record go. In a few moments, we'll be having Harry Nilsson's new single.
And now, commercial radio classics bring you Let's Plug Mendelssohn into the Mains.
Desperately pleasant. And before you bother to send a stamped addressed envelope, I'll tell you what it is over the wireless. It's Mendelssohn's Scherzo from A Midsummer Night's Dream, one of the frilliest pieces of music ever writ by the hand of man. We'll be back with Harry Nilsson in just a mo. And now, as promised on Victory, Harry's new single, all the way from the States, not released yet.
Something true to show you what I am to you. Something real to cause your heart to rush with love, and cause your mouth to rush to mine, and make your eyes ignore what isn't. But all my life I failed to take advantage of my time, and time is moving faster than the eye can see. If we could only tell each other every other day, something real to show that I still feel.
Isn't he wonderful? Harry Nilsson and Something True. Comedy break.
Yes?
I'm from the Performing Rights Society and I've got a complaint.
What?
You're not performing right.
Comedy break.
Did you know that the little Sussex village of Rotting Dean was named after a decaying clergyman?
Are you kidding me?
For your delight, Splinter and their new single, Which Way Will I Get Home? And now on 95 FM, we bring you Queen.
Ooh, nice.
Cheers and instant.
grew. The work devoured my waking hours, but when my time was through, the reward of all my efforts, my own limited company.
Sure, when this one's finished. I think it's finished because.
Is this the real life?
It's the next track, and that's just come on, so it must be finished. Queen off their new LP called A Night at the Opera. That was Good Company, spiffing track done by Brian May. Comedy break.
We take you back in history to 1881, where the political revolutionary Karl Marx is about to say the words that would shake the world for years to come.
Just say the secret, Wade, and win $100. Tonight's Wade is...
No, no, Karl Marx. Karl, not Groucho. Karl, Karl, you dummy.
I'm sorry. Of course, you know this means war.
Comedy break.
Here is a newsflash.
I say, you fellows, what do you find in a snooker table and in a man's trousers?
I don't know.
Pockets.
I need somebody who's consistent with me. Someone already there when I need company. 'Cause when I'm feeling low, I don't wanna have to go out looking for a part-time kind of love. And when the dreams and rainbows start to disappear, I don't want somebody up and running out of here. 'Cause when you stop and start, baby, it's just too hard upon my heart, that part-time kind of love.
I can't take
you, darling, living here, wait and see.
I want somebody
who's committed now to me.
Somewhere,
chance.
If you like the
music, baby. starting to dream. I know we're gonna find our share of peaches and cream. And when the juices flow, I don't wanna, no excuses, that part-time kind of love. Just want your full-time love for me.
Part-time love for me.
Just want your full-time love for me.
Love it. Gladys Knight and the Pips on Victory, Part-Time Love. Great. Well, nice to see you in the charts. Glad. Do you know it's Dick Van Dyke's birthday today, folkies? It certainly is. And tomorrow, let's see whose tomorrow is. Well, let's have a bit of birthday music, shall we? Tomorrow's birthday... Oh, nobody was born tomorrow. Day after, on Monday, it's Dave Clark's birthday. And day after that, which is Tuesday, nobody was born. Oh, Sir Noel Coward was born then. Wednesday, Tommy Steele and Dave D. And Patricia Plunkett, whoever she was. Thursday, we have Keith Richard of the Stones. I think that's all. Yes. Friday, we have Eamon Andrews. Hee-hee. Born 1922. And Sir Ralph Richardson, also on the same day. And on Saturday next, whose birthday is it? Oh, it's Jess Yates! Hee-hee. Contest time right now after our birthday spot. This one's... slightly difficult. Four Beatle tunes. The first letter of each title spells another group. See if you can guess it.
Nothing you can do can be done.
How does it feel to be one of the beautiful people?
Christ, you know it ain't easy.
Oh, I have got another girl.
Okay, groovers. Those titles spell another group. Have a little think amongst yourselves, and we'll be back in just a second with the answer. Okay. Pat on the back time if you got it correct. The four titles were All You Need Is Love, Baby You're a Rich Man, Ballad of John and Yoko, and Another Girl. And those titles, the first letter of each, spells ABBER. So, if you got ABBA, give yourself a pat on the back. If you didn't, a kick in the bum. Here's the Hollies from their double LP package just out called History of the Hollies. This one's 1964.
When we were at school, our games were simple. I played a janitor, you played a monitor. Then you played with older boys and prefects. What's the attraction in what they're doing?
Hey, Carrie Ann, what's your game? Now can anybody play? Hey, Carrie Ann, what's your game? Now can anybody play?
You're always something special to me, quite independent, never caring. You lost your charm as you were aging. Where is your magic disappearing?
Hey, Carrie Ann, what's your game? Now can anybody play? Hey, Carrie Ann, what's your game? everybody play.
For 64, read 67, okay? Carrie Anne by The Hollies, and that carries us out of the show. I've been warming up the seat for the person next to me. I hope they appreciate it. Here's a little electronic get out. See you next week. Bye!